Chevrolet. I rock Z Camaro, courtesy of folks at Cody Chevrolet on the Marymount Hilly Road. Ambulance service by Paramed of Richmond, Vermont. Rector service here at the Nation in Sight of Excitement, courtesy of Blake Amoso on Route 14 in East Montpelier. Works left. Fire protection by the East Ferry Fire Department. The Cody Chevrolet Thunder Road infield crew and last week's feature winners will introduce them in a moment. Tigers and the Owl Lumber Street Stocks. Before we get things underway this evening, as always here at Thunder Road, we'll introduce last week's feature winners. As a result of Mother Nature's dirty deed, we've only got half as many, but here they are. Feature winner, first of all, in the Allen Lumber Street Stock Division, car number 22, the Lackalane Lumber Chevrolet Wild Water and Brew, your defending champion. And in the Pepsi Flying Tiger Division, a rookie driver picked up his first of the year, first lifetime on the Tiger Tour, the Green Mountain Paving, East Ferry Auto Sales, Mopar, car number 12, Bobby McCaskill of Williamstown, Vermont. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we've got ourselves an overflow crowd tonight. If you folks in the grandstand have got any room whatsoever, you got half a fanny space between yourself and your sweetie, just kind of slide over just a little bit if you would. Still folks looking for seats. If you're sitting next to someone of the opposite sex that you don't really know, well, slide over anyway. Who knows? It could be your night. Low handicap, main event for the Allen Lumber Street Stock, held over for 1 week ago. Car number 13, Allen Renfrew, will go on the point outside the 14 of Ted Devardy. The 08, Scott Robar, outside of Robar, Bob Mohan, number 57. Steve Hamlin, Don Ray will go next. The number 29 is Teddy Kingsbury. 27, Scott Allen will go in the 7th spot. Outside the Wild Man of the 99, David Moritz. 77, Steve LaFountain from East Montpelier. Outside of LaFountain, took his heat and the semi last Thursday night, and he's in the running for a triple crown right now. Car number 4, Tony Andrews. Next on the grid, Dan Ladd is racing cab. The Cadillac Seville Big Daddy Donald Hughes, car number 66. We've got about 8 guys scheduled to start this thing that haven't made it onto the racetrack, so the tickets are a little bit cheaper for the guys in back. Looking for his first feature win. Scott Allen is the 27th. Keep an eye on the back of the pack. That car number four, Tony Andrews, he dodged the bullet. He is on the lead lap and still now in the running for the Triple Crown. We'll see what he can do.
The 66 of Big Daddy. Here we go! Please,
tad warm, too. There's Big Daddy climbing out of there. Steve topping him at 25. The 66, the 28 are both a lap down. How do you like that? Big Daddy was all poofed up, now he just let the air right out of him. Steve Copping wins it. Bob Bovat, well, you come out and get your trophy if you want. Look at him, he's having a seizure in there, he's so happy. Look at him. Keep him away from me. Casey, you handle him. Bob, congratulations.
Thank you very much. You're excited, that's for sure.
I'd have never guessed it. You got some people you want to thank here?
No, I've done all the work most of myself. Brendan Mooney taught me quite a bit, and I sure do appreciate the people here coming to watch this fantastic sport of mine. Great, man.
Can't add a thing to that. Bob Bovat, you're a winner. We're told that third place is trying to fight his way out of the pits right now. You guys are a wacko. Let's get our winner here. Come on, Pitsley, hurry up. Steve, come on down here. Steve Copping, congratulations. Nice job out there. Start dead last, win the race. You can't do much more work than that.
Oh, it's not working pretty good tonight, but I like
it. Got a little screwy out there. We didn't know who was where, but you made it real easy. You just led all the way.
I tried to get out in front and hold them off, but I'd like to thank all my sponsors, Blackback Photo, Club 302, Giant Beverage, and Check Cooking Excavating. Thanks, everybody.
Steve Copping, the winner in the number 25. Mellon gets the trophy. Oh, here comes Scott now. Scott Allen is our mystery third place winner. Scott, come on right out of here. We'll do this the easy way. Whoa, mule. You want to get out or you want to stay in? You'll stay in, all right. Scott, congratulations. I don't know if you knew you were third or not. We didn't. He didn't either. The helmet's still on. Throw his trophy. We're going to get run over here. Scott Allen, 27. Congratulations. Good job. Third place finish. All right, we'll start with the Tigers.
Chevrolet Camaro, number 23, and Mike Potter.
He's coolest tour debut last weekend in the Canadian Maritimes, the T.K. Gibson daughter Chevrolet, car with 36 and Scott Carpenter from Waterbury. Outside of Carpenter comes the Simmons Cable TV, Guyette Electric Chevrolet, the number 29 Brett Wheeler of Waterbury, Vermont. Next on the field comes the Office Department Store Buick, car number 40 from Morrisville, Dwayne Lanphier. Outside of Lanphier, the Dave Service Center, Sitka Racing Pontiac, car number 25, and Dave Whitcomb. Inside the next row comes the McIntyre Fuel, Ford Thunderbird, the 98 from Essex Junction, Vermont, Keith Waddell. Slated to go alongside Lamell comes the Village Sitka. Car number 33, Camaro, from Waterbury, the High Flyer, to Ford Expo. Series Garage, Tri-Town, Sunoco, Racing Pontiac, next on the field, from the Granite City of Barrie, Burger Lake, in the 27. High Point driver, once again this week on the Pepsi Tiger Tour, car number 68, from Grunt, Vermont, the Dolly Trucking Chevrolet, Jim Silley. Winner of the Times Argus Mid-Season Championship a couple of weeks ago will go next on the field, the number 5 Pontiac from Eastmont, Hillier and Jeff LeCair. Next on the starting field, three-time feature winner in 1989, car number 13, from Williston, Vermont, Roger and the Bob Boxy. And going shotgun on the field, the R&J Sitco Chevrolet, car number 85 from Barry, Vermont, and Mike Pelkey. Ladies and gentlemen, that's your starting field. We ask now that you please rise to the playing of our national anthem. right front slick bolted on and get him back in action. Well, I'd love to find Dion to ride the Enduro. Alex Hart Jr. and keep an eye on the 49 mark. finisher, the Bouchard Chevrolet, Mark Laffey in the 49. Mark, congratulations. Neil Pops here had yourself a pretty good race for second place.
Yeah, the track got a little slick there partway through, and I went to the outside of Norm and I thought I could get a shot at him, but I got in the wall and it slowed me down and I let Jerry go. The car's been going better every week after the mid-season race. We're getting stronger. Now I'm just looking forward to the Enduro.
All right, he's going to run the Enduro Saturday night. We'll see if he can do as well. Mark Lampy in the 49, third place tonight. Where's Pops? Grandpa Jerry in the pit. Not too bad for old man in the used car.
Norm and I go back a long ways, but he had a little more power than I did tonight.
You and Mark had a pretty good run. He said the outside was a little slick, you agree?
Yeah, it was. The inside got slick there a couple of times, but then it cleared out and the outside got real slick. I didn't dare go up there.
You kind of just been pecking away on this car all season. You're getting closer and closer every week.
Yeah, the car for an inexpensive car goes pretty good.
Grandpa Jerry, he was number two tonight. Jerry has to go in the 90. Well, here's a fellow that's worked hard for this one. Stormy Norman, the number two winner. Norm, congratulations. A couple of weeks ago, you were in the top three. You told us you needed more motor. I think you found one?
Well, I don't know that I've got more, but I got one that goes the distance, and that's what counts.
Had all the help you needed out there. Jerry Driscoll and Mark Lampier kept the heat on, but you were able to keep a couple of car lengths between you and them.
Yeah, I've been around quite a while. I kind of worked Mark a little bit. I didn't know what I was going to do with Jerry. Jerry's been around more years than I have.
That's hard to believe, isn't it?
Myself.
Congratulations, a super run. Norm Andrews, the Precision Auto Glass. You got to thank the folks here, too.
Yeah, I want to thank them, my sponsor, Precision Auto Glass. I want to thank all my crew. They did a good job helping me put this thing together. Thanks.
Stormy Norman, first of the year in car number two.
36. The yellow flag's out. Haven't come close to a green, and they're racing. Look at them. These guys are certifiable, every single one of them. The 31 is Ralph Kettle, 29 Debbie Kingsbury.
Half down, half to go.
right up these steps as soon as possible. There's no hurry, though. He's about to get a free soda out of this deal, so... All right, we'll have 18 grown-ups up here crying, "Oh, Lord! Where's my soda?" Ryan Kilburn, in car number 50. Carrying the checkered flag at 1 and 2. Was about a quarter of a mile from here, right down on the bottom of Quarry Hill. Keep Cuban in the 04. And cars ready to start. I guarantee they don't want to hold that. Steve Morin on the outside of the 99. Steve Hamlin down low on the 8. Morin leads it. Hey, this is going to be great. He holds the Thunder Road season record for most winning races.
Thank you.
yard field goal right through the uprights with him. Seymour Bidwell coming down to pick up the flag, but it's not the one he wanted. Nice try, Seymour.
Oh, Lord.
Steve Copping somehow manages to win it. The third place guy. Seymour says, what gives here, man? They're going to let him keep me like that. Randy was just kind of flogging around out there in eighth place. I think he finished third over. Oh, I gotta, you gotta love the crunch punch. Seymour still doesn't understand it. Now, I read my Bible and I cry, baby. Steve Copping in the 25, your winner. Hey, how about a round of applause for Seymour? You can't fault the effort. His ankle's a little faulty, but he had the right idea. See, those guys won't let him keep them pretty for long. Steve Herdedeff, the 76, has got a big lead in the point standing. 67 points coming in tonight. We'll start shotgun.
Yeah.
tearing. That was an absolute flyer. Tough break. Couple of drivers that have really begun to find their way around the last couple of weeks. Mike Mott and Jeff Perry. We have everyone back away from the fence, please. Everyone back from the fence. Worse. number four challenging for third slapped the wall, and that was all she wrote.
Okay, holding away in the 86, McCaskill.
Yeah. job, Wayne. Super run.
Thanks, Ed.
You and Wally had a pretty good go at it for a second.
Yeah, there was no way I was going to hold it down, so I just let him know. Car was flying tonight.
Super run. You three guys got out there and really just kind of ran away. Had to play the lap cars pretty hard, too.
Well, just going to work for that.
Happy with third?
Definitely.
Wayne Barber, the 28th, third place finisher tonight. Well, man, what a run through in second. Wally, super job. You guys had a heck of a race going up there. If it hadn't been for this kid over here, it would have been for the win.
Thank you. I got locked up the top. I tried to go as fast as I could. I thought it was going to be slippery tonight, but it's pretty good.
Wow, and luckily, 22-year-old up. Wow. Wayne Barber, the 28th. Okay, everybody, grab your tickets. It's time for the draw now. Somebody's going to walk out with $1,563. A new Thursday night record, so get your ticket. And we'll have Radical Randy Drawler for you in just a second. All right, let him hear it. We know you love him. Radical Randy, Randy. All right, I asked you 3 weeks ago. You were off the track of him. You were still hitting the wall. I see a mirror in there tonight. What's your excuse?
Well, the way it would go is wide open.
You gotta love it. All right. 3 wins this year for the wall, man. You get to reach in and draw the 50-50 tonight. So plunge that hand in there. And we have got, read it off, a brown ticket.
001412.
You passed the test. 001412 for the 50-50. And if they don't show up, you can have the money. I want to remind you, ladies and gentlemen, we've got the 02250. Sounds like somebody on the hill might have gotten it. Let's have a cheer for Ray RX9. Last 3 weeks. Andy Bowright and Kevin Holcomb, Wayne White and Red Mead, Jim Martin and Mark Graves. Butch Elms wants the slow start. The old dirt tracker will set the pace. Here they go. Out of here, number four. Thank you.
go. I had no choice but to barrel into that one. Travers Associates, Lord Fairmont, going up on the record. Front straightaway, it's on the road.
second place finish, Jim Barton is third, CBL's taking up the checkers. Feature winners tonight, Jim Barton in third, Wayne White second, and CBL picks up the winning car number six.